This video explains how you can manage repositories in your Azure DevOps account. So on the left hand side, you can see that if you log into your project, you will see the repos tab, and then in that there are several links there, like files, commits, pushes, branches, tags, pull requests, etc. So once you click on files, on the right hand side it will display the project structure or the repository files. And from the top you can choose the repository. Right now I have selected PHP Selenium tests, but normally there are different repositories that are there. You can see I have got lots of repositories, and I can just, let us say I want to work on WebDriver, I will just click on WebDriver IO, and then that repository will be opened. You can navigate through the files. If you want to edit any file, you can edit it right from here in this master branch, but it is normally advised to create a new branch and then make changes in there. So you can create a new branch right from here in this interface and then make the changes, commit it, and then all the commits will appear here. You can select your branch as well from here. Right now it is showing the commits that have happened on this master branch. Similarly, if somebody has pushed changes, it can be seen here. So you can see here these changes have been pushed, updated Azure pipelines or YAML, and if you click on that, it will show you exactly which repository and where that what change was made. So you can see here this push was made to the master branch in this repository and so on. So you can see the details for each and every project from here. So normally, since we have selected this project WebDriver IO or repository, it is showing the pushes for that particular repository and this branch in that repository. If you want to see the pushes for different repository, you have to select this repository and then you can see the pushes. So same way, the first thing that you need to do is you need to select the repository at the top, and then you can see commits, pushes, then branches in that repository, tags related to that repository, and then pull request for that repository only. If you are not able to find your files, repositories, or say pushes, branches, then most likely you haven't selected the correct repo there at the top. Then in the branches, you can see different branches that are there. You can create a new branch like that. Let's create a new one. Normally this convention is like this one: feature hash slash and then a hash ticket ID, say 1122, and then based on the branch and work items to link, say if you have created any ticket, then you can link it here by typing the name and then click on create. So you can see now there is another branch here, and you can check that branch out as well right from here. For example, if you want to see the files in that branch, just go here, select the branch, and then you are right now in this branch. You can make the changes here, then create a pull request. So let us create one change here. Say it's new file, .txt file. So this file is created. I'm gonna commit it. So that's it. Now the one commit has done, and then you can see here. It is showing I have committed one file to this branch. Do you want to create a pull request? I'm gonna create a pull request, and then from this branch to master branch, added this text. You can add the reviewers here, and then click on create. Then pull request will be created, and this is how the pull request looks like. Here you can see the overview. If you want to make any comments, you can put the comments there. You can see the files that have been changed in this pull request. It will not show all the files that are there in your repo. It will just show you all the changes that have happened. That's it. In the update section, if you, let us say in the same branch, if you get the review comments and you make new changes, then if you make the push in this branch, pull request updates will be shown here. You don't need to create another branch. You can make the changes in this branch itself and then push the changes, and then reviewer will again review your changes. So those updates you can see here, and then commits are here. And then if the reviewer is there, he can either approve or decline, reject, approve with suggestion, that's possibilities are there. And once he approves, next thing that you need to do is merge this branch into master, and that can be done using complete button. Just click on complete and then merge will happen. If you do mark as draft or abandon, changes will not be merged to master branch. You can also follow this pull request. You can cherry pick the changes. You can view merge changes. Restart the merge. In cherry pick, what happens is only selected changes will be picked up. For example, out of say you have done 4 changes in the pull request and you just want to pick one change, then that is possible from cherry pick. So all these possibilities are there, and it's very good user interface. I'm very happy with this and comfortable with this repository section in here in Azure DevOps. So I didn't show you how to create a new repository. Just quickly I'll show you here. You can create a new repository, import repository, manage repositories. In manage repositories, you can delete the repository. The import repository, you can import from other sources, for example, GitHub. And then in here, you can also fork it. If you want to clone the repository on a local machine, you can clone it from here. And then you can select either HTTPS or SSH. And remember that if you want to push changes from local to here, you will have to set up the Git credentials as well. If you are using SSH, you will have to manage SSH keys in this. You can also create personal access tokens. You can add public SSH keys here, and alternative credentials can also be set up. Thanks for watching this video.